dear students. Today we are going to study a new topic, that is delegation of authority. So this topic you may not be much familiar, the delegation of authority, because you are not might have listened to the word delegation. Okay, so this delegation of authority means the manager who is in the higher position will be having a lot amount of work. The workload of the person will be very much high. So every time it is not possible that he himself will be doing all the jobs. Okay, so what he will do is that he will hand over the job to a subordinate. Okay, some job, not the every job that they are doing, but some amount of job that they have to perform will be handed over to another person or to a subordinate. And when he is giving this job, so simply telling somebody that you do this job, okay, so better this will not be possible. So if the job has to be handed over, then there's a sufficient amount of authority also has to be handed over, so that the person will be able to complete the job. And when authority is handed over, then he will, the accountability also, making him accountable for the job, means he will be answerable to the work that he has to perform. See, for example, see, like if I am LCA in charge, okay, so then his father will be telling me that you have to arrange a program for the Independence Day. So it is my response. Now this is the my duty. Okay, so I have to arrange all the job related to the Independence Day program is there. So every program, everything we have to arrange. So this is my duty. But it is I am having other duties, or I may be busy with some other activities. So it is not possible that everything I will be doing by myself. It is not possible that one person will be doing all the job by myself. Okay, so what I will do is that I will divide my job. Okay, so like what are the programs that I have to perform, that I will that we have to do, that we will decide, and I will assign one job. See, for example, one group song is required or patriotic song is required, so I appoint one person as a in charge. Okay, and I give this job, I give tell, see, like I am telling the Joy Seaman, so I am telling Joy Seaman to take over the work of the patriotic song. Okay, and I hand over another work, maybe one speech is required, so that speech I have given to one another person. And drama is there, or a skit is to be played, then that I have given the job of this one to another person. So I will be appointing different people for doing this job. Okay, so this is called the delegation of authority. So when I am telling, see, for example, I am telling that one person that you have to take the patriotic song. So when I am telling that you do the job of patriotic song, then the duty of making or arranging the patriotic song is given to another person. And when that responsibility is handed over, then authority also is handed over. See, for example, if I am telling you that you can take the patriotic song, so she will be responsible. She has the authority to decide what song, which song has to be played, how long, how much should be the length of the song, and how many members should be there and in the team. Okay, so she can decide that which class, which song has to be played, and which who all will be singing. So she will be selecting the members for the this one. So how many has to be participated, who all will be there, who all are the singers, or she will decide whether to select the children from smaller classes, or from middle class, or from higher class, so which is suitable. So all these type of things, she has the authority to take all these decisions. Hope you understand. So I have given the work of doing this, like you arrange one patriotic song, this much I have told. So, and I gave the responsibility that you can decide the song, whatever song, maybe the song that is there, and you can decide who will be singing and how they will have to sing. So that also she will be doing the activity. She can consult me for any other things, or any kind of clarifications required, then she will be asking me permission. There is no need of asking permission, but then she can discuss with me regarding the result. So authority is given. And if, see, for example, on 15th August the patriotic song is not ready, then the I can ask her, why have you, I have told you that you have to prepare this one, then why have you not complied? Okay. But see, for example, I am responsible for the mail. See, like that accountability cannot be delegated. So that we will discuss in the later. So if a father will be calling me and asking me why the patriotic song is not ready, then I have to give answer to it. Okay, I cannot say that I have told the Joshi ma'am and she did not do it. So that is none of father's business. So father has told me that you have to arrange a program, Independence Day program should be ready. Okay, so it is my responsibility that I have to see to it that the things are ready or not. So it is, I have to go and ask to that person whether the things are ready or not. If the things are not ready, then what is the problem? And if that person is unable to perform, then I have to appoint another person or I myself have to arrange the things. Okay, so this is called the delegation of authority. Okay, so this is the meaning of the delegation of authority. Okay, next let us discuss about the definition of delegation of authority. Okay, so according to F.G. Moore, delegation of authority means that assigning work and to others and giving them authority to do it. Okay, assigning work to others and giving them authority to do it. Okay, so giving some job to one person and giving them authority to do it. Okay, as I told you, if a work is given to me, see, like if father is telling me that you can do this, okay, you have to do work of this. But if I don't have any authority, I don't have, see, like if organizing this program is there, so father has told that you can arrange the Independence Day program. Okay, but the father has not given me permission to practice some time, additional time, or during the class, or even after the class, I have to take some time for practicing. Okay, and if I have no permission for that, I don't have permission to take other teachers, appoint other teachers, or if I don't have permission to call the children, then I won't be able to perform. So when I have any work is given to me, then I should be given some authority also, some power also should be there to take the decisions. So it is there should be, I should have the power to make the decisions, how many programs should be there, what should be the different type of program, what sort of program has to be arranged, all these type of decision making power should be given to me so that I will be able to perform this. And I also should have the power to decide who will be performing, what will be, what sort of programs has to be there. And I can discuss it with the father, but some power should be there so that I will be able to make the decisions. You understand? So that is called the delegation of authority. Now let us discuss the elements of delegation. So when we hear the word delegation of authority, there are some elements that we have to study, some important points that we have to study in case of the delegation of authority. Okay, so the first point is called responsibility. The responsibility is that, you see, like if work is given to me, then it is my obligation to perform the job. So responsibility is the obligation to complete the job. Okay, so father has told me to arrange a program for Independence Day. So I have the obligation to do, make it, arrange it. So that it becomes my duty. Okay, so when work is assigned to me, then it is my job, my work. And if I hand over this job to another person, it will become the responsibility of that person to take care of this. Okay, so if I have given patriotic song to one person, one dance to another person, then it is the it becomes the obligation for that person to complete this task. Okay, so otherwise he should not accept this one. So when I am asking that you have to do this one, then he or she should say that, sorry sir, I am unable to do this one, I am busy with some other work, and please find someone other person. So when we are giving, when authority is given, delegation of authority is done, at the time itself they have to decide that, they have to say that it is not possible by me. And if that person is telling that okay, I will do, then it will become their responsibility to complete this. So arranging the patriotic song is the responsibility of that person, whomsoever it is handed over to that person. Okay, so that is the responsibility. Responsibility means, you might have this responsibility, you are very much familiar. See, like if any work is given. So your father is telling you that you have some work is given to you. It is your responsibility. And now the main responsibility of yours is to study. So you are in 12th class and now it is your responsibility to study. So mostly the teachers are telling you that you are irresponsible or you are not being responsible for these words, you are very much familiar. Okay. So responsibility means that dutifulness or the obligation of completing a task. So now if I tell you that it is your responsibility to study, so now this is the main responsibility that you are having is to study. So if any other job or when you complete your studies and go for a job, so when you start doing the job, then the job. See, like if I am working as a teacher of business studies, it is my responsibility to teach you all the business studies subject. Okay, so this if any of the students are not able to understand the business studies or if the class is not delivered, so I am responsible for it. So that is my responsibility to complete. And if the syllabus is not completed on time, or if the mark, if the students are, or if like practical exam has to be arranged, and if you are unable to perform for the practical exam, project has to be there. So when external examiner is coming and asking where is the project, and I say that I don't know, then it is my responsibility. I have to hand over, or I have to make you ready for the this one. And it is my duty that I have to tell you that you have to perform the, you have to prepare the project. And all of you are, and I have to see to it that you are doing the project and submitting the project on time. And the projects are ready, and I will have to check the project and see to it that all the pages and all the works are done by you, completed, everything is ready. So if the work is not completed, then I have to be answerable to it. So it is my responsibility to hand over complete this. Then next element of delegation is the authority. Okay, authority means the power to take decisions. Okay, so when a responsibility is given to me, I should have the authority to make some decisions. So whatever may be the job that I am assigned, I should get some authority also to perform this job. Okay, so I should have some power to make decisions. Like if I am teaching business studies, so I should have the power to decide. See, like today which chapter I have to teach, how much. Like if like business studies, one book is given and one topic is given, the period also is allotted. So it is, I have to situate that which chapter I have to start with, and how I have to teach, which method has to be used. All these type of decisions I will be handling. So that is the authority given to me. So I can make, I can decide what sort of classes should be there, and how the classes has to be there, which chapter has to be completed, how many chapters. Syllabus and all is already given, but within the syllabus, so I have to see to it, time I have to use. One day if I don't take class, but next day I have to cover up that portion. So how much area, how much syllabus is there, so that I have to cover up. So this is my, that authority is given to me. So I can make decisions. So today which chapter has to be there, and in that chapter which topic I have to teach. So what way I will be teaching, all the decisions, and regarding the questions, answers, or discussing about all these type of things. So all this authority is given. So the authority, all the power, power to take the decisions. So when power is not given, then responsibility is given, and no authority is given, then work cannot be completed. Okay. So when work is given, then there should be authority also to do the job. Then the third step or the third element of delegation of authority is called accountability. Account, you are familiar. So accountability means that answerability. Okay. So see, for example, if Independence Day program is arranged and the work of that is given to me. So now see, I am accountable for the program. If the program is not ready, father will not call any other people, but first he will call me and ask me why the program is not ready. So I have to give answer, what is the problem. And at the moment, last moment, if I go and say that the children are not ready or children are not ready to come, any kind of issues, so these type of problems are there, earlier itself I have to go and inform father, then get permission, or if any other facilities are required, all the things I have to arrange. I should not simply sit there. Like, first of August itself, father has given the duty, and at the end of the period, or just on the 14th, father is inviting some guests and all, and asking me, are the program is ready or not. Then if I say that it is not ready, then I have to give answer. So the accountability means that we have to give answer to the superior officers who has given us the authority. So it is means we have to give account to it, or we have to give answer to the questions what they are asking. Okay, so that is called the accountability. So when a delegation of authority is done, all the these three things are delegated. So responsibility is given, authority is given, as well as the accountability is given. Okay. Then the next heading is that can the accountability be delegated? Okay. So delegation of authority is possible, but accountability, can the accountability be delegated? See, for example, father has given me the job, and if I hand over the duty of doing this program to another person, then can I say that I am not responsible? It is not possible. So the answer will be no. The accountability cannot be delegated. Okay. So the I will be the major responsible for the work that has to be completed. Okay. So if work is not completed, father will call me and ask me only. Father cannot. And if I say that I have given this duty to this particular person and he or she did not do it, then that will not be a problem. Okay, so that I cannot say that you just asked that person and ask why it is not ready. Okay, so there is no any issue of asking to another person. I can ask that person why it is not ready, but father will be asking me. Okay, so I have to give answer there. And after that, when I am getting scolding from father, or if father is asking me something, then after that I have to come out and ask to another person to whom I have given this job, I can ask why you have not made it ready. Okay? But the accountability remains with me. Okay? I have to give the responsibility. So this accountability cannot be delegated. So even though the authority can be delegated, responsibility can be delegated, but accountability cannot be delegated. I am the accountability. Some extent of accountability can be delegated to another person, but fully this I cannot say that I am not responsible for it. Okay, so that is not possible. Okay, then the next topic that we have to study is that this delegation of the division of labor is the basis for a delegation of authority. Okay, see, like there is a connection between the division of labor and delegation of authority. So delegation of authority means that handing over the job to some other person. Okay, and the division of labor means that the work is divided into small tasks, and handing over this task to another or a different people, the subordinates. Okay, see, like if I am planning to conduct the Independence Day program, so all the work I will not be able to handle. So what I will do is that I will divide the work. Okay, so first I will decide that how many programs should be there. So if I have decided that there should be some 10 programs, and some around 2 hours program will be there, and there will be like for some march past will be there, band members will be coming and playing some music, national anthem, one patriotic song they will be playing, and they will be marching and coming, then there will be flag hoisting, then flag salute. Okay, different programs are there. The one prayer dance will be there. So different programs will be there. So I will decide what are the programs that has to be conducted. Then I will appoint different people. So I will also select that who will perform this. Okay, and I will also assign that like this teacher will be in charge of this one, and he will be doing those activities there. Another person will be in charge of this one. So I will give this task to different people. So that is called the division of labor. And when the division of labor is done, so at that time this delegation of authority is also done. Okay, see, for example, patriotic song is given to one person, and he becomes, I am handing over, delegating authority of a patriotic song to that person. Okay, march fast. So I am telling the Shashikant sir to take over the work of this march fast. So I am delegating this duty to, so that division of work is the basis of all these activities. Okay, so when I divide the task, then only I will be able to hand over this task to another. So first the division of work will be there, the entire work is divided into small tasks. Then after that we hand over this job to another different members. Okay, so hope you are able to understand. So today we will conclude with this topic. So you hope you are able to understand the delegation of authority. Delegation of authority means that giving the task, giving the work to another person. Okay, so when I am handing over the work to another person, then he will become responsible for doing that task. Okay, then thank you so much.